Hi and welcome to this quick tutorial on the Lansweeper SCCM integration. Lansweeper now also scans SCCM servers and lets you basically gather data from those servers as well. So you can pull in the asset data from SCCM into Lansweeper as well. The widget here itself just gives you a quick overview of the data that has been retrieved from SCCM. So you can see which or how many assets were scanned by SCCM or how many assets were scanned by both Lansweeper and SCCM and some other fields here as well. So the idea behind integrating SCCM with Lansweeper is to allow you to do cross checks. So you can find blind spots or assets that you're missing in either SCCM or Lansweeper for some reason. So you can really have that complete coverage regardless of which tool is scanning the device. So we'll take a look here at a SCCM scanned asset. We'll actually take a look at the SCCM server that we've scanned. So here we have a SCCM server that we've scanned with the new SCCM scanning target. There's a little less information than you're used to with Lansweeper. That's simply because this information has only been scanned with the new SCCM scanning and not with the Lansweeper scanning. So there's not as much information. What we do have is some basic information about the OS, the memory, the processor. We get the antivirus as well. And if we head to the config tab, we can see the new SCCM tab here with additional information. So we'll take a look at that. So we have our general SCCM information that we've retrieved. So a bunch of OS information, PC model, domain, some small hardware information there, like the physical memory. And we also get the BIOS serial number. Then the more interesting information here, especially for an SCCM server, is the sites. So you get to see exactly which sites are managed by that SCCM server. Here we only have one site, and we can also take a look here at the assets that are within that site. So we get a complete list of all the assets that are managed by that SCCM site. Those also get an asset within Lansweeper. So as you can see, they're all hyperlinked here. So we can navigate to any of these SCCM assets as we want to. Now, aside from the site details, we also pull back software from SCCM assets. So this is the software that has been scanned by SCCM, not by Lansweeper. It's important to make that distinction. Normal Lansweeper scanned software will still be in the software tab. If you want to take a look at the SCCM software, you'll have to go to config SCCM and then take a look at the software there. Again, this is mainly for cross-referencing, seeing if there's any inconsistencies, double-checking, etc. Lastly, we also check the network adapter info, and we pull that back from SCCM, so you can take a look there as well. So now that we've seen an asset scanned with the SCCM scanning, we'll actually take a look at an asset that has been scanned by both Lansweeper and SCCM, kind of to give you that perspective as well. So we'll head over here to our new asset. So this is a asset that has been scanned by both Lansweeper and SCCM. As you can see, instantly there's a lot more information here that has been added. That's just the normal Lansweeper scan. The SCCM info, just like the other asset, is under the SCCM tab here in the config. So if you want to take a look at that, we can do so. So here we have the SCCM specific information that we've retrieved from SCCM. And that is very similar to the previous one that we've taken a look at. The only thing here missing is a site, because this is not a SCCM server. This is just a asset managed by SCCM. Another thing to note here is that on the bottom right-hand corner, you'll see the SCCM server listed. That's an easy way as well to tell if your asset is an SCCM asset or is managed by SCCM. It will list the SCCM server there, and that's also hyperlinked. So you can quickly navigate to the server if you want to take a look at that. As well as you can view the client data. So if you don't want to go to config SCCM, you can simply click on view client data and I'll bring you straight to that information. So to truly start using all of this information that you've retrieved from SCCM to do your cross checks, you can use the new built-in reports that we've added. So if we go to our reports and take a look at the new SCCM reports. So we have a handful of new built-in SCCM reports. The first one, Lansweeper versus SCCM, shows you all of your Lansweeper assets and indicates whether they've been scanned by either Lansweeper, by SCCM, or by both. Then we have a report specific for all the assets that are only scanned by SCCM, so that haven't been scanned by Lansweeper yet. This is a useful report to take a look at. You can find here assets that haven't been scanned by Lansweeper, and you can kind of find as to why they're not being scanned by Lansweeper. Maybe a scanning target that is not set up yet, or something else that has gone wrong. As we've seen, it's always recommended that you scan an asset with Lansweeper as well, especially if you want that added detail of information, since the information that SCCM does provide for any type of asset really is just slightly less than Lansweeper. So similar to Chromebook scanning, SCCM scanning also has a new scanning target. So if you add a new scanning target, you'll see that in the list here, there is SCCM scanning that has been added. Similar to Chromebook, basically all you need to do is just enter your credentials at the top and then indicate which SCCM server you want to scan. Again, if you need more guidance for this, we have a knowledge base article that explains all the steps on how to scan your SCCM server. So you can take a look at that if needed. And once you've set it up, simply just hit OK and you can start scanning your SCCM server. Thank you for watching. If you want to learn more about Lansweeper, head over to our website, start your free trial, or take a look at these videos.